In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, we bless you, and we love you. Thank you, Lord, for every spiritual blessing that you have bestowed on us. Thank you, Lord, that as we have come here to study, to seek, to learn diligently about your kingdom, about your words, thank you, Lord, for your wisdom that you have provided, that you give us when we ask. We get to know everything of your kingdom, and we, in turn, are wise to be in this world. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God, for taking over and teaching us all that is important in the Word of God. All that we need to keep in our hearts, all that we need to act upon, all that we need to apply and be victorious in the Lord. We ask this in the most glorious and blessed name of Jesus, and all God's people said amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Amen. Okay. So, I'm coming with a very, very simple scripture, the favorite of all. That is John 10:10. Where it is written that the thief, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Let us see. Let us put it on the screen and see. Okay, just a minute. Give me a minute. Yeah, so I hope everyone can see it.
Yes, sister.
So it is said the thief comes not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and life, and that they might have it more abundantly. So let us pay attention on the first part of this. The thief comes not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. Now, whenever we say the thief comes not but to steal, kill and destroy, whom do we think about? Whenever we talk about the thief, whom do we think about? Who is the thief?
The devil.
Yes, we always think of about the devil. We tell that he is come to steal, he is come to kill, and he is come to destroy every relationship. We will always blame the devil, right? We will blame him. But is the choice, suppose given a choice, to speak to somebody harshly or nicely, is the choice mine? Is the choice mine?
Yes.
Yes.
When I want to speak some words, now I'll, you know, why am I paying attention on this? Why am I drawing attention on this? Because whenever we spoke about the scripture, we always have spoke that it is the evil one who comes and who tries to snare us. But in what form does he come? He will not come directly and snare us. He will come in the form of people. He will come in the form of people. Through them, he will try to destroy us. Through them, he will try to kill us. Now, how can a person kill another person without touching also? How can a person kill another person even without touching that person? By are words.
Words.
When we slander somebody, when we criticize somebody, when we speak wrong about someone else, when we try to bring a person's character down, that is the time we murder someone, we kill someone, we destroy someone by doing the work of the evil. We never paid attention on this. We always, whenever we see the scripture, we always think, no, the devil comes. But how does he come? He comes in form of people. He comes and operates through people. And we may also be a channel to him if we do not pay attention on ourselves. If we are not vigilant on ourselves, we tend to go into that. We tend to go, if somebody comes continuously against you, and especially your loved one, okay, somebody from the family only, may it be your loved one. Now that person is not ready to budge. He is not ready to change. He is not ready to give a good word. What happens to the person who is taking patience? What happens to the person who is in the Word of God? What happens to the patience of the person? Even after doing so much, that person is unable to see the changes in the loved one. Then what happens? The moment we see that there is no changes, we get frustrated. And when we get frustrated, now whatever we were giving in love to our loved one turns into disaster. Then our mouth opens for the wrong words, that there is no use of doing so much things. There is no use of being good. There is no use of giving agape love. There is no use of this. There is no use of that. Now you are frustrated. You are fed up. And now when we are frustrated, when we are fed up, when we are irritated, now the words of death comes from our mouth. So we need to understand that the devil does not come directly. He comes through people. He may also use us if we are not vigilant. Keep it in mind. We've seen many, many people in the families or in authorities and organizations. We've seen that they make utter use of their designations, of their posts, or of their relations, even in the families. And we've seen many of them insulting or giving a bad term to somebody else. We've seen it in families also, especially elders who cannot be, when they are angry. They speak something very bad because now they are very angry. They want to show their anger. And to show their anger, they want to use something that can hurt somebody else, that can pull down somebody else. So the thief comes, but to kill is when we operate in his kingdom. When people don't understand, people slander someone, they are having lack of knowledge. Do we hear many people keeping names to people? They'll keep all funny names. Somebody will say, hey, that fat so is come. Somebody will say, hey, see, that skeleton is come. Somebody says, see, that glutton is come. Somebody will use some very other weird names. They will keep a name to a person. Somebody will say, see, the chicken is come. See, the coward is come. So anything can, when kept names, you are slanderizing a person. And we in the world do that a lot. We slander someone, and when we do that, we are supporting the kingdom of darkness. We are supporting that evil one. And then we suddenly feel it's just a joke. Nothing that comes out of a mouth is a joke, because every word that comes out of a mouth is spiritual. Every word is a spiritual word, because we cannot see words, just as we cannot see God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, just as we cannot see the evil spirit. In the same way, we cannot see our words also. Now, when I'm talking to you, I cannot see my words. I can only hear them, but I can't see them. And when I can't see, it is spiritual. And that's why it is said, death and life are in the power of our tongue. What happened to Jesus when Jesus went to his own hometown and he was spreading, he was giving the knowledge of the kingdom of God? What happened to him? The people of his own hometown started teasing him. They started saying, is he not the son of that carpenter? Is he not this one? Is he not that one? They started judging him on from where he's come. And because of that, they made a big block in front of them. And that blessings that the Lord had for everyone couldn't reach his own hometown, because they had blocked their own blessings. We need to know, are we also blocking our own blessings? Are we also going in a wrong way? Are we also unknowingly speaking about someone? Are we also unknowingly slandering someone? Are we also unknowingly murdering somebody's character? Are we also putting somebody down? We need to know. We need to be vigilant. And why am I saying this? Because we are still in the world. We are dealing with different types of people. And not everyone is in the world. So they try to deal with us the world way. When we try to deal with them the world way and nothing is happening, suddenly we see that we lose our temper. We lose that grace which we were walking in, and we lose it, and we just want to give back thoroughly. So we need to understand. So when we say the thief comes but not to steal, kill, and destroy, it's not the thief only, but it is the thief through someone, through somebody. And that somebody can be me also. Because only and only Jesus was perfect on this earth. Only and only. So let us understand. Let us understand the scripture. Now, when we speak about blessings, 1 minute. There is a scripture. It speaks about blessings. 1 minute. I will just put it here. See what this says. Genesis 12:3, the Lord says, and I will bless them that bless you and curse them that curse you. So the Lord is very concerned about us. But just as this promise is given to us, the same promise is given to each and every brother and sister of ours on this planet Earth. So imagine if we are not vigilant on our talks, on our thoughts, on our deeds, on our actions. If we are not vigilant and by mistake we remove a wrong word from our mouth for someone else, the Lord is not partial. The Lord loves everyone equally. And now the Lord is telling that person against whom we are speaking that I will bless those people who bless you and I will curse those people who curse you. So let us not think that all the blessings are only for me. It is for everyone else. So be vigilant. One wrong word from your mouth and you are going to curse God's loved one. The one who came, who the Lord gave his life for. So let us be very, very vigilant. Let's take one more scripture just. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but a perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit. Let us take another version to understand it more better. It says a soothing tongue is a tree of life, but a perverse tongue crushes the spirit. Means a soothing tongue means a gentle tongue. A gentle tongue is a tree of life, means it gives life even to a person if that person is on the verge of death. A gentle tongue. But a perverse tongue, a tongue who speaks only all the ill, that tongue crushes the spirit of a person to whom you are speaking. So, let us be vigilant of every word that we use, because if we also use words against somebody else, we are operating in the kingdom of darkness. We are supporting the kingdom of darkness and we become a part of that kingdom of darkness. Let us be vigilant enough in our thoughts. Let us be vigilant enough in our words, deeds, and actions against someone else, because just some time back we seen what Genesis 12:3 says. So the Lord is equal to everyone. We cannot just open our mouths and curse anybody. We cannot just open our mouths and speak a wrong word against anyone. Because if the Lord takes charge, then that can hurt us. Yes, we are redeemed by the curse of the law, but it does not say that that allows you to speak wrong against someone else. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Proverbs 11:9 says, let us see. Proverbs 11:9 says, with their mouths, the godless destroy their neighbors, but through knowledge the righteous escape. With their mouths, the godless would destroy their neighbors, but by knowledge, the righteous are delivered. Means, with their mouths, the godless would destroy their neighbors. Means, destroy means when you speak something ill about your neighbor, about your sibling, about your parents, about your spouse, about your colleagues, about your children, about your friends. So with their mouths, the godless, the people who have no knowledge of the word of God, would destroy their neighbors. But the people of knowledge, but by the knowledge, the righteous are delivered. Because we got the knowledge, the righteous, that is we are delivered from every evil thing. So we know that the Lord has made us righteous. We are aware. We know that it is not our doing, but the doing of Jesus on the cross. So when Jesus has given us righteousness free, let us keep that righteousness by not getting angry on anyone, by not slandering anyone, and not using wrong words against anyone. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, and we bless you. Thank you, Lord, for making us understand the true meaning of the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Lord, till now, we all were under the impression that the thief comes in various ways, but we never understood that even we can be a part of it if we are not vigilant enough. And we can be a part of somebody's destruction. We can be a part of somebody's sorrow. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for giving us this knowledge, for making us understand the truth, that we can be a part of that stealing, that killing, and that destroying of somebody else's life and be a partaker in the kingdom of darkness. Thank you, Lord, for with this knowledge, we apply the truth and we see that we never, ever, even by mistakes, support the kingdom of darkness. But we walk in the kingdom of light by doing all that the Lord has instructed us. This we pray in the mighty and glorious name of Jesus. And all God's people said, amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.